Children, welcome back. Today's topic and today's chapter is quite very interesting, and it is completely a new thing for us. What is that? We are going to know about matter. But to know about matter, first we need to know about mass. Every day we see a variety of things around us. They differ in size, shape, color and many other things. Suppose if we take a book, a science book and a Bengali exercise book, both have a different size and both have different colors. Now if we are going to take a table and a chair, both is different in size, shape, color and many other things, like the structure as well. Like this way, if we choose different kinds of thing, we will see that each and everything has their own shape and size and color and many other thing. But there are some common features that are shared by all things. That two such features are mass and space. Now, when we visit a doctor, the doctor first, he or she asks us to, or they measure our weight. But if your weight is suppose 30 kilos in Earth, if you go and visit in Moon, your weight will be not 30 kilo, it will be lesser, because I think you must be knowing about gravity. Gravity is a power which pulls down everything. And in Earth, we are not flying in the air, but whenever we have seen an astronaut, we have seen they are nearly flying in their space vehicle. From that, we can understand this is all about gravity. Gravity is nothing but a special power which the Earth has. It pulls down everything towards its center, towards its core. We have already know about the Earth and its core in the previous chapters. So, mass, the amount of matter or substance. So, what is mass? The amount of matter or substance that make up an object is known as mass. All objects has mass. Mass is the quantity that tells us how heavy or light an object is. For example, in one hand, you take a brick and let us go for an easier example. In one hand, you take up your bottle which has filled with water. Now, let us understand this thing with some examples. What is mass? It will be easier for you. In one hand, you take a bottle filled with water. And in the other hand, you take a sharpener. Now, which one is heavier? Obviously, the bottle filled with water feels heavier in that particular hand from the other hand. So, we can understand from that bottle is heavy and the eraser or the sharpener, if you are keeping on the next hand, it's light. So, mass is the quantity that tells us how heavy or light an object is. So, the feeling that you are feeling that this one is heavy, this one is light, this feeling is about light and heavy is known as mass. All objects take up space. For example, if we are going to keep up some clothes, that takes up place in the cupboard. If we are keeping some books on the table, it is taking up space. If we are keeping some plates and glass and bowls on the dining table, then it is taking up space. Anything which has mass and occupies space is called matter. Means weight and space, these two is equal to matter. Now let us understand with few more examples. Suppose we are going to keep one brick and one feather on the floor. Now, can you blow a feather? Yes, we can blow a feather. But can you blow a brick? No, we can't. So, the feather is light and the brick is heavy. Now, everything around us is matter. How? Air, water, solid, everything. Matter includes both living and non-living things. Now, as you have learned about living and non-living thing, we can tell that a book, pencil, eraser is also matter. A human being or a tiger, dog, elephant, bird, everything is matter. If it is air, if you are blowing a balloon, that is also matter. So, mass is the quantity which tell us about heavy and light, and matter is that which occupies space and have mass. Now, states of matter. Matter exists in three different forms or states: solid, liquid, gas. Different materials are grouped under different states on the basis of their qualities. So, let's learn about first form, which is known as solid. So, solid, anything that has a fixed shape and size is called a solid. It can neither change its shape nor can flow. Like river flows, but river is not a solid, it's a liquid. But we will move on to the liquid, not now. First, let us understand what is solid. So, anything that has a fixed shape, size is called a solid. So, kettle is solid, we can't change the shape. A stone is solid, we can't change the shape. A car is solid, a glass is solid, a plate is solid, a book is solid, a container is solid, a chair is solid. So, there are many more things which are solid. Table, chair, pen, pencil, floor, all are solids because they have a fixed shape and size. Now, let us understand what is liquid. Anything that does not have a fixed shape and size and can flow easily is called a liquid. Anything that does not have a fixed shape and size and can flow easily is called a liquid. Suppose water, milk, fruit juice, oil, etc. all are liquid. Now, how you will understand that this is a liquid? They do not have a definite shape and they take the shape of a container they are kept in. Suppose you are taking a glass of water. Water don't have a shape. So, whenever you are pouring the water into the glass, it is taking up the space. Now, next, whenever you are pouring that same water into a bowl, it is taking up the shape of the bowl. Now, if you are pouring the same water into a plate or into a different kind of cups or mugs, then it is going to take that shape. So, a liquid always flows. We all know if we are pouring the water on the plate and it don't have a side barrier, then it will flow down and it will fall down off your plate. So, they do not have a definite shape, size. They take the shape of a container they are kept in. So, this is very important. These are actually known as the features or the characteristics or the functions of solid or liquid, what I taught you still now. They can be poured, liquid can be poured and spilled, while a solid cannot. So, this is a difference between a liquid and a solid. Now, let us know about what is gas and its features, function or characteristics, what you called it. A gas is matter that has no shape, no size, even we can't see a gas. It fills all available space. Gases cannot be seen. We can feel them and even smell some of them. How we can feel a gas? Whenever air is blowing, we can see a storm going on. We can feel the air. The oxygen we breathe in and the carbon dioxide we breathe out are gases. Our atmosphere is also made of different types of gases like oxygen, carbon dioxide, nitrogen, and there are many more. So, when we are flying a kite in the sky, we are flying it in with the help of that gas. Whenever we are flying and balloon, that is with the help of a gas. Even we are blowing a balloon, what we are blowing in inside, that is occupying a space, that is gas, right? So from this we have understood the three forms of matter. Now we are going to learn about the change of states. Now we know what are the states. So there are three states: solid, liquid and gas. Matter can change from one form to another. This is called change of state. So when a matter, means a solid, liquid or gas, changes from one form to another, suppose solid to liquid or liquid to gas or gas to solid or gas to liquid, like this. This is called change of state of matter. For example, water exists as solid, liquid and gas in these three forms. We can change water from one form to another. Yes, absolutely. Whenever we see water, we know the three forms. One is ice, one is basically water, and when the water gets boiled, it changes. Now let us understand how the change of states of water can take place. In solid state, water exists in the form of ice, snow and frost. So what are the three forms? Ice, snow, frost. There are three states when the water solidifies. One is ice, one is snow and one is frost. When it changes into liquid state, it exists only as water, and steam is the gaseous state of water. If you take a bowl full of water and you heat that water, you can see some of the hot smoke is coming out after the water is hot. So that is the gaseous state of water, which is known as steam. The process of change of a solid, means ice, into liquid, means water, is called melting. So when the process of solid, means if you have a ice and when the ice is outside the fridge, put it in a bowl, after some minutes or after some few hours, you will see that there is no ice left in that bowl. There is only water. So this is called melting. Then suppose you take that water and in a bowl you put it inside the refrigerator, and after few hours later, when you take out that water, you will see that it changes into a solid form, into ice. This is called freezing. So when a liquid, means water, solidifies into ice, is called freezing. The process of change of a liquid water into gas, means steam, is called evaporation. Already I told you how to do that experiment to know what is steam. And the last process of change of a gas into liquid is called condensation. Now, suppose you are boiling water on the gas and the water is quite hot. So you put a lid on that, a glass lid onto that pan or something where you are boiling the water on the gas. So after a few minutes, you will see some water droplets on this glass lid. From that, you can understand that steam changes into liquid or water is known as condensation. As we have heard and understood the whole chapter, let us recapitulate or recall what we have learned today. All objects have mass. Mass is the quantity that tell us how heavy or light an object is. All objects take up space. Anything which has mass and occupies space is called matter. Anything which has mass and occupies space is called matter. Matter exists in three different states: solid, liquid, and gas. Matter exists in three different states: solid, liquid, gas. Matter can change from one form to another. Matter can change from one form to another. Water exists as solid, like ice, snow, frost, as liquid, that is water, and as gas, that is steam. The process of change of a liquid into gas is called evaporation. The process of change of a gas into liquid or water is called condensation. The process of change of a liquid into solid from water to ice is known as freezing. The process of change of a solid into liquid is called melting. A gas is matter that has no space or size. Anything does not have a fixed shape and size and can flow easily is known as liquid. Anything that has a fixed shape and size is called a solid. Now, solid can neither change its shape nor can flow. For example, solid like table, chair, pen, pencil, they are solid. Water, milk, fruit juice, oil, they are liquid. Gas, it fills all available space. Oxygen which we breathe in and carbon dioxide which we breathe out. So that are gas. All objects take up space. Now children, it's time that we should learn the spellings very well. Otherwise, there will be a lots of mistakes while you are writing the answers. So let us learn the spellings. And the spellings you have to learn are, there are so many spellings in the book, but I have chosen few for you. Rest, whatever the spelling you feel that is difficult for you, please learn those spellings as well. So the first spelling is mass, M-A-S-S, mass, M-A-S-S, mass. Features, F-E-A-T-U-R-E-S, features. Space, S-P-A-C-E, space. Variety, V-A-R-I-E-T-Y, V-A-R-I-E-T-Y, variety. Eraser, E-R-A-S-E-R, eraser. E-R-A-S-E-R, eraser. Scale, S-C-A-L-E, scale. S-C-A-L-E, scale. Light, L-I-G-H-T, light. L-I-G-H-T, light. Heavy, H-E-A-V-Y, heavy. Sharpener, S-H-A-R-P-E-N-E-R, sharpener. S-H-A-R-P-E-N-E-R, sharpener. Occupies, O-C-C-U-P-I-E-S, O-C-C-U-P-I-E-S, occupies. Exists, E-X-I-S-T-S, E-X-I-S-T-S, different, D-I-F-F-E-R-E-N-T, different, D-I-F-F-E-R-E-N-T, different. Forms, F-O-R-M-S, forms. solid, 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 liquid, 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 materials, 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 liquid, 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 container, 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 spilled, 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 oxygen, 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 atmosphere, 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 breath, breathe, breath, available, 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 frost, 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 evaporation, 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 steam, 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 condensation, 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 freezing, 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 melting, melting, melting.